Transcription. Transcription means here RNA production, process of copying of genetic information from DNA to RNA. So that is DNA to mRNA production or DNA to RNA production is called transcription. Here the enzyme is involved, the involved enzyme is DNA dependent RNA polymerase enzyme, also called as transcriptase enzyme. So where the transcription is happen? So at the nucleus on the DNA, the transcription is going on. So the DNA have the segment that is transcriptional unit, there the DNA, the transcription is going on. So what are the features of the transcription unit? So the transcription unit is basically having the three component, three major component. One is the promoter region, another one is the structural genes, and next terminator. So it means three basic components are present in the transcription unit. What is transcription unit? Transcription unit is nothing but of DNA segment, but where the transcription is proceeds, that place is called as a transcription unit. Here you observe the transcription unit, it composed of basically three major components. One is promoter site. Promoter site means where the enzyme, what is the enzyme? RNA polymerase. What type of RNA polymerase? That is DNA dependent RNA polymerase. The DNA dependent RNA polymerase is binded to here at the place of promoter. There it screens the promoter region, then from there the initiation is started. So what is the next? Structural genes. Structural genes are proceed or elongation of the transcription, they are involved. Terminator region. Terminator region also called as a segment of DNA, but where the DNA RNA polymerase is reached, there the termination of the transcription is happened. So that region is terminator region. When you observe it here, upstream level and downstream level. Generally the DNA is double stranded DNA. While it is involved in the transcription, it must able to open up or to make unwind. So after unwinding only, after separation of the two strands only, one of the strand work for the transcription. So the strand which is going on, it means on the strand where the transcription is going on, the strand is called template strand. Template strand also called as antisense strand. So another strand also there, opposite strand, that strand do not involve in the transcription, it do not code anything. So that's why that is called coding strand, also called as sense strand. Why it is coding strand means, you see here, in this transcription procedure, the mRNA is produced, the transcript is produced, the formal transcript is more or less similar to the coding strand. Instead of the thymine, only uracil is present. That's why it is said as coding strand. For example, you see here, this is the DNA. So the DNA is having the, so T, 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 C, C, G, 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 A, A, A. So this is the one of the strand of the DNA. And another complementary strand of it means you take as A, 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 G, 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 C, 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 T, 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 3 dash. So this is, what is this? This is double stranded DNA. When the double stranded DNA in the involved in the transcription, it must be open, one of the strands only involved in the transcription. If the upper strand, this is the template strand, for example. So this strand is involved means, on what type of the mRNA is produced means, you see here, 3 dash, T, 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 C, 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 G, 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 A, 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 Y dash. So, transcription results. So, here the produced RNA is having A, 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 G, 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 C, C, C. Here, instead of thymine, the uracil is present. So, you see here, you compare with these two. So another strand of the DNA, it means coding strand of the DNA, similar to the production of mRNA, produced mRNA. So AAs are present, but instead of the thymine, the uracil only present. That is the difference between the coding strand and also formed mRNA. So that's why here two strands are present. The strand which involved in the transcription, that is called template strand. Another strand is coding strand, similar to the mRNA. Okay, so and you come to the what is the procedure for the transcription. So already I told the enzyme involved in the transcription, that is RNA polymerase enzyme. So DNA dependent RNA polymerase enzyme. Why it is DNA dependent RNA polymerase means, if you take the sum of the viruses, so RNA is a genetic material. There RNA to RNA production also happened. On that condition, the involved enzyme is RNA dependent RNA polymerase. But here in the transcription, from DNA to mRNA, the genetic information is copying here. That's why the RNA polymerase is completely dependent onto the DNA. That's why it's denoted as DNA dependent RNA polymerase. Okay, but here you are seeing the procedure of transcription. So already I told where the transcription is going on, that is called transcriptional unit. So here the promoter is most important region. So the enzyme, so you are seeing here the enzyme. So before going to the transcription, so the enzyme is most important, RNA polymerase enzyme. So it have two subunits. It means RNA polymerase enzyme. So it have sigma factor and core enzyme. These two are the part of the RNA polymerase enzyme. So what is the sigma factor? So the function of the sigma factor only for initiation of the transcription. So here when the RNA polymerase screens the promoter region, when it is binded to the promoter region, the sigma factor initiates the transcription only. After initiation, it separates from the site that separated from the RNA polymerase, and core enzyme only proceed the further transcription. So basically the transcription is said in the form of three stages. One is initiation, and another one is elongation of transcript or mRNA synthesis, and termination. So in the initiation part, first the RNA polymerase can screen the location of the promoter. There it go and join to there. The sigma factor work for the initiation start. So after initiation, the sigma factor separated from the RNA polymerase, only core enzyme continues the elongation. So you see here in the initiation, it go and bind to here. After binding here, it can opens the DNA, double stranded DNA. So the segments are opened up. It means two DNA strands are opened up, and one of the strand on the template strand, the RNA transcription is going on according to complementarity. Okay, so according to complementarity, the RNA is produced. So newly produced RNA in the process of transcription, that is called transcript, also called as nascent RNA. Okay, so here in after initiation, so the sigma factor is separated. So here the core enzyme only involved in the elongation of the strand, and when the enzyme is moving to 3'-5' direction, when it is reached onto the termination region, there it terminates. It means the core enzyme become inactive. There the transcription will stop. At the termination region, the transcription is stopped, and there from there the RNA will, newly formed RNA or newly formed transcript get separate. Then after the separation, it gone to the processing, RNA processing. So you see in prokaryotes, already I told, so in the prokaryote it is very simple. It means only dependent enzyme, that is the RNA polymerase, DNA dependent RNA polymerase. But when you come to the eukaryotes, the three types of the RNAs are present: mRNA, tRNA, rRNA. So but here work division is allotted to the transcription. So in eukaryotes, three types of the RNAs: mRNA synthesis and tRNA synthesis and rRNA synthesis, made by different types of polymerases. So what are the polymerases? RNA polymerase 1, 2 and 3. So RNA polymerase 2. Polymerase 2 is work for responsible for production of mRNA. RNA polymerase 3 is work for tRNA. RNA polymerase 1 is work for rRNA. But in prokaryotes, there is no work division, only one and only one enzyme. What is that? RNA polymerase, DNA dependent RNA polymerase work in prokaryotes. But whereas in eukaryotes, three different types of the polymerases, RNA polymerase 1, 2 and 3, are work for the three different RNAs production.